Hello, ladies and gentlemen. We've been to Brazil, we've been to the Rocky Mountains. Now it's time to move up on the American continent and cross the border to Canada. And if I'm not totally mistaken, or even if I'm mistaken, I do anticipate, I expect my friend and colleague Lisa Endler to make herself seen. She is, there she appears. Hello, Lisa.
Hello,
good to see you. What's the weather like in Montreal?
Actually, today is a quite sunny day again. We had some pretty cold days, even in May, but now it's getting warmer and I'm pretty happy about that.
Good. And now, as opposed to Denver and the Denver area, I think, what's the time? You're around 7-ish, 7 a.m.?
It's almost 8, let's say.
Oh, okay, that's okay. I don't feel guilty for calling you up this early.
No, it's okay.
Thank you. So, Lisa Endler, she has been working a long time with the Jena Fulda Festival. She has been studying in the Weimar University, the wonderful compartment of media, art, and design, and she's made her master's degree in immersive media art. It's been an amazing piece. Last year, she was production partner in the Cirque du Bauhaus Immersive Theater, which many people have seen. Today, she's in Montreal, and I think I want to ask her about two things, because these two pillars her career rests on. The one is immersive theater. What the hell is that? And the other is immersive academic research. What is that? It's your choice, but I ask you to start with immersive theater, because that's also something that we haven't talked about in the Framers Forum. Lisa Endler.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, thank you, Mickey, for this nice introduction and also just for having me in the Framers Forum. I'm really excited about that. I'm going to start to talk about immersive theater a little bit. As you already mentioned, I was a former student of yours, and I also became a teacher of the immersive media at the Bauhaus University. And then I also had the chance to work for the Fulda Festival. But even before that, I was kind of intrigued with immersion as I was studying in Leipzig. I was studying drama science there, and I got kind of into this topic of immersion by Stanley Kubrick's 2001 Space Odyssey, very well-known film, I guess. And I had my undergrad about that. I was writing about the immersive strategies in Stanley Kubrick's film. And then I also had the chance to kind of get into stage and costume design for several theater plays. And then I came to Weimar and met you, Mickey, and got the chance to get to know this really, let's say, broad field of immersive theater, this kind of really great way of doing media art by combining several different aspects and several different techniques of doing media art. And so I contributed my first Fulda episode, Crystal Cave, to Hotel zur Blauen Blume. And ever since then, I was just hooked to the medium. So I also got the chance to be there at the Fulda Festival in 2015. And I was just really into the whole dome and everything that can be done with the dome as a canvas. So I was really struck by this situation of seeing the dome as a canvas and as a backdrop also for 360-degree immersive theater. I have never seen something like this before, so I was really happy you introduced it to me. And ever since, we have been collaborating on several projects, which one of these was the Cirque du Bauhaus performance last year. And what we did there was actually to combine several Fulda episodes done by students, but also by media artists. And we combined this with the music of the lovely Cirque du Bauhaus Orchestra, which was conducted by Acacio Piedade. And we also had performances, live performances of Kunstfiguren and also an interactive light costume, like a dancer on stage. It was also corresponding to the movement in the dome. And so by this, we tried to really get a kind of a Gesamtkunstwerk and try to push also the limits of the dome even further. And I think we've done a fairly well job with this.
Yes, I agree. You're right. It was great.
It was amazing. I had a lot of fun. And one of the things that is really for me, one of the, or not maybe one of the most, but really one of the striking things about Fuldom or immersive theater is that it is a highly collective thing. So first of all, we see it in the dome, which is already a collective experience with lots of people being there in the dome, which kind of makes it also different to, for example, VR theater, for example, which also exists. So yeah, there is this really nice way of showing people a play, and they all have a different perspective on it. And then there is also this notion of just, it is a collective work of art also. So I got the chance, or we got the chance, to collaborate with so many different artists from so many different fields and get this together into the dome in front of an audience. And that is for me like, yeah, one of the most intriguing parts of immersive theater. And then also just to have this kind of, yeah, huge canvas where our students can actually just put their imagination up. So we get really into the skulls, let's say, of our students, not like literally, but yeah, we get into the imagination of their heads. And that's
almost literally, we get into the skulls of people.
I hope yeah. Not too much. Yeah, but yeah, you know what I mean.
We are no neurosurgeons or something like that.
Not yet. So yeah, and this combining of live performance and also the unlimited spherical canvas of the dome as a stage is kind of a really unique thing to me. And I think what is also important to remember is that Full Dome Theater is also about weaving the dome with the real world and thereby expanding the dome also beyond the simulated space. And we can really expand the dome even wider, so lift the horizon of the dome even wider. I don't know if that's really possible, but I think we do it in immersive theater.
Well, and it's yeah. Our motto says, lift your horizon. So we have to do what we preach. And thank you for connecting that. Now, you made a brilliant analysis and description of what the medium, what the genre of immersive media all entails and contains. Now, that's all the good news. Now, the bad news is that right now, May 2020, that's a nice way to say it, we can't be in the dome to experience what you described, but we are preparing to do so later this year, and also to find places to find venues where this genre is being practiced, explored, and where it can continue. So I think it's fair to say that you are also involved in a project called Kur Commander, which we are hope to perform later this year. And that will kind of bring the idea of live performance and also of TV series and dome worlds into a new Gesamtkunstwerk. So we always a little, yeah, we are creative risk takers, and I'm glad you are teaming up to that. We need kind of the solidarity of risk takers. So we don't want to tell too much about Kur Commander, just sort of saying, Kur Commander, okay, let's get people excited about it. Now, as you are in Montreal, and as you are an accomplished media artist and media scientist, you ventured to kind of open up a new chapter in your life and in your study. And unless you have something important, APS on the immersive theater, which I kind of cut you off from, which of course you are free to say, you may also shift over to say, what is the other big thing that is happening with you right now?
Yeah, just maybe one little thing about immersive theater. It is also, I mean, you just already mentioned it, it's also a really highly experimental space. And that's, I think, one of the also really unique things about immersive theater, that it is a really open place and you have to stay curious and just imagine the unimaginable. That's one of the things that I try to do in immersive theater. And yeah, it's kind of like this really highly flexible and unlimited 360 degree environment where we can really place a lot of interesting theater. So yeah, about the academic research group, I guess you were pointing at.
Yeah, exactly. Now good, now that you mention it, exactly. That's what it was. Academic research group. And exactly. You are right in the center of it. Tell us about it.
Yeah, so during my work also with you as a teacher and just, yeah, being also a producer of Fuldo Media, I often ask myself, has this been done before? And if so, by whom and where and how can I find information about that? So I was also thinking, what do my fellow producers and researchers think about the work that we do actually in Jena, in Weimar? So I had a lot of conversations, like eye-to-eye conversations with people about that. But I also want to have like the big conversation with a lot of people and researchers. So yeah, I actually want to start a conversation with, which is about Fuldom, but also teaching Fuldom or immersive media. And so when you talk to me about the Immersa Academic Research Group, which is a joint initiative of the Immersa Summit and the Fuldom Festival Foundation, I said, yeah, of course, I want to participate. I mean, that's just what I've been looking for. And it's really, I think, interesting to get into touch with other researchers and to stay in touch with them. And I think there is already some platforms that do that, which is, for example, of course, the Immersa Summit itself, or festivals like our festival, the Fuldom Festival, or also the FDDB database. There's different kinds of versions of how to get in touch with each other. But I think that it's also, yeah, there is like this rapidly changing tech situation also happening. So there's lots of different research in different places from different people. And I have to say, I don't have an overview about that so much. So I was really curious about how to get in touch with those people, how to really also maybe find out how do other teachers of immersive media teach their future Fuldom enthusiasts and immersionists what they need to know, what kind of teaching techniques are there, what do I really need to know. And I think one really good thing is that we now have this really brilliant handbook that you also contributed to, which was published by Kate McCullum. So that's one of the bases. But I think that, with this academic research group, we also try to find even more links and even more ways of maybe collaborating with each other. Yeah. And so one of the first things that we need to know to do that is actually to have the contact of each other, the contact dates, like an email address, or just to know where we are placed. So with the help of Dan, I crafted a kind of questionnaire for everybody who's interested, actually. People can set down, so where are they located, what kind of fields are they researching in. They can list their academic publications and also give links and ideas of where we can see their work, so other people can see what they're working with. And then also I asked in this questionnaire to give like an idea of how interested they are in certain projects or future projects, like certain topics, like, for example, immersive theater. So this is a questionnaire I was sending out to a few people in my address book so far, and I gathered some information already, but we're looking to widen that horizon, of course, and to spread it to even more people and to make it accessible to even more people. And then my wish would be to have a kind of a website where we can actually interchange also more about this, so have a kind of a database again, which really is concerned with academic research in the field, and which kind of really sums up everything that we have so far in this really broad and ever-changing environment of Fuldom and immersive media.
The ever-changing environment of immersive media. Yes, we are on a sliding scale. We are on a steep learning curve, and you are one of the mountaineers. And thank you for preparing this questionnaire. I just want to make this enhance this invitation that you just said. Now, first of all, earlier this morning, we had the conversation with Immersa, with the board, with Dan Nefus, whom you mentioned, and other people from the Immersa board. And now the Fuldom Festival is produced by the Fuldom Festival Foundation, which is a nonprofit organization out of Jena. And so these two groups, in the spirit of cooperation and collaboration, said, let's find out who's doing what and who and where. And so we're very happy that you, from your new abode in Montreal, can just reach out and people can find you to get to know the questionnaire, fill it in. And so the the knowledge on what you're looking for is really getting more and more. If whoever watches this now wants to contact Lisa, you can always write to the contact address of the Fulda Festival, and we'll forward this, and then you'll get this brilliant questionnaire, which was, again, worked on with Lisa and some people from the Immersa Summit. And maybe next time we meet again, you have 10,000 of questionnaires. And you'll just have to do data crunching and checking what is now new about the immersive theater, the tech, the new development of 360 players and other things that are dearly needed in the world. So yes, am I right in kind of communicating your invitation out to the world that is watching us now?
Definitely, definitely. I think I will also maybe just link my address at the Facebook feed so people can just contact it right away. I will later post a link there with my address, l.endler@fuldumfestival.de, I think. I will just, post it there
Lisa, what does punkt mean in English?
Okay, dot, I guess.
Lisa.endler. Wonderful.
Sorry, yes. It's still early in the morning, so.
You'll post your address. This is great. You'll get a lot of fan mail, and then you can see what the response will be like and how you kind of analyze it.
Yes, I mean, so far I already got some response, and I'm really thankful about that, that already some people filled it in. And I can already see that the range of fields that people work in is really so broad. Like, I mean, it goes from interface for dome environments to data harvesting, to music and media arts, to visual music, to experimental use of smartphones in the full dome, to interactive media, to interactive theater, to art, science, humanities, technology, and VR gaming. So there is like a huge range of already like of those fields. So just to say, it's not only about immersive theater, it's really about the whole immersive spectrum. And yeah, so that's really an interesting topic, I think, and I'm looking forward to get involved with more people and to get more into conversation and also to learn from each other and to maybe collaborate more, like we, for example, did already with Ricardo Del Farra when he was taking some of our students' works back to the festival in Buenos Aires last fall, I think. So stuff like this could happen even more frequently, and I think we all can kind of really get something out of this. And I'm already also in contact with Marin Kiesling, for example, and Julieta, also from the Immersa Summit. And so we're kind of trying to build this framework and trying to build this academic research database kind of. And I'm looking forward to that.
Wonderful. So people in the world, immersivistas and friends of immersive life and studies and evolution, check the stream underneath this Facebook post and you'll find where to contact Lisa, and so that conversation will be going, as with so many other conversations that have been going. And I must say, as one of the organizers of the festival, we are really moved, deeply moved and honored that in the time where practically nothing could happen in so-called reality, the community and their activity and their willingness to share and discuss in the virtual realm is really overwhelming and totally encouraging. Mm-hmm. And if you look at the talks that I had the privilege of listening to with all you people in 3 days Frameless Forum, that is already quite a resource and a statement from so many sides of individuals, of organizations, that life will go on, and as clean and happy and healthy as we can imagine, we are unbeatable in our commitment to happy, healthy, safe life. And so thank you, Lisa, for your particular contribution.
You're welcome.
We'll be in touch from Melbourne to Jena. It's only a phone call away. And everybody else in the stream, you can take a two-hour, it's about a two-hour break. Get your pizza, get your whatever drink is in the fridge. make sure your kids are all right and the cat gets enough food and the dog is being walked out, and take a deep breath underneath your mask. I was asked the other day, is mask, has this any to do with mascaroni? No. I was asking for a friend. No. Very, very bad joke. Not even a joke, just bad. Anyway, at 4 o'clock p.m., Central European time, the streaming will continue with magnificent full dome shows. And at 9 o'clock p.m., Central European time, we reveal who is winning the Janus in the 2020 contest. We have 7 Januses already prepared, and tonight, 7 people will know that they've won a Janus. The big Oscar award, no, it's higher, it's above Oscar to get a Janus in the Fulham Festival. And there are also some honorable mentions. So come back at in 2 hours for the Fulham Festival stream. Come back at 9 p.m. for the announcement of the award winners, and stay there and don't go away until Pedro Zas, Speto, and the United VJs get you up and dancing all over the world. This is my message. I see you later. Bye, Lisa. Bye, everybody else.
Bye, Nikki. Thank you very much.
Have a good break. Talk to you soon.